Fuel is essential for air defense, and the role of US Air Force tankers is to keep jets supplied on critical extended missions. The McDonnell Douglas KC-10 Extender was appropriately named as it extends the combat range of fighter planes and bombers. The aircraft type is actually a modified McDonnell Douglas DC-10 and is said to retain 88% of systems commonality with its civilian counterpart. Of course, for its role in the military, it has additional systems and equipment. For today's video, let's take a deep dive into this soon-to-be-retired aircraft type. The KC-10 Extender made its maiden flight on July 12, 1980, and officially entered into operational service with the US Air Force on March 1, 1981. As mentioned in the introduction, the type was built by McDonnell Douglas, which merged with Boeing in 1997, as a military version of the DC-10 civilian airliner. The DC-10, of course, came out first, making its maiden flight on August 29, 1970, and making its commercial debut via American Airlines on August 5, 1971. We noted at the start that the KC-10 had 88% commonality with the DC-10. So what made the two aircraft different? Well, as noted by the US Air Force, the KC-10 has military avionics, an aerial refueling boom, and aerial refueling hose and drogue. The type also had a seated aerial refueling operator station and aerial refueling receptacle and satellite communications. The aircraft can transport up to 75 people and nearly 170,000 pounds or 76,560 kilograms of cargo, a distance of about 4,400 miles or 7,040 kilometers unrefueled. In addition to the type's three main DC-10 wing fuel tanks, the KC-10 has three large fuel tanks under the cargo floor. These are located under the forward lower cargo compartment, in the center wing area, and under the rear compartment. Combined, the capacity of the six tanks carried more than 356,000 pounds or 160,200 kilograms of fuel, almost twice as much as the KC-135 Stratotanker. A minimum crew for the aircraft included four positions: a pilot, co-pilot, a flight engineer, and boom operator. Certain missions required additional crew members. For example, in aeromedical evacuation missions, you would have had two flight nurses and three medical technicians added. According to the US Air Force, the jet had a cost of $88.4 million in 1998 dollars. Using an inflation calculator, this would equate to around $170.3 million in 2024. Given the KC-10's superb reputation for quality and the invaluable service and tactical advantage provided by aerial refuelers, it's a tad surprising that the Extender hasn't had more extensive foreign sales. However, the Royal Netherlands Air Force was the type's only international customer. By contrast, Chile, France, Singapore, and Turkey have purchased the KC-135 Stratotanker at one time or another. Digging further into the research, it turns out that the Royal Netherlands Air Force took two civilian market DC-10s and converted them to KC-10 specs with the designation KDC-10 instead of buying airframes built from the ground up as KC-10s. The Dutch retired their KDC-10s in 2021. However, the Extender did provide service to one other foreign nation's military, albeit via a private party intermediary. The commercial refueling company Omega Aerial Refueling Services operated a KDC-10 that supported the Royal Australian Air Force's FA-18 Hornets in 2011. Perhaps not coincidentally, Omega also purchased those retired Dutch Air Force KC-10s. A total of 60 KC-10s were produced from 1979 to 1987, and since their adaptation by the US Air Force, they've served faithfully in several conflicts, including those in Libya, Iraq, Yugoslavia, and Afghanistan. One interesting aspect about the service life of the KC-10 is that it has been outlived by a much older aerial tanker. Indeed, the KC-10 was designed and selected to supplement the Boeing KC-135 Stratotanker, as the latter was exposed as somewhat lacking in flexibility during operations in the Middle East. Indeed, some 20 years ago, the KC-10 was expected to serve until 2043. Despite the extender's greater flexibility and versatility than the Stratotanker, the latter is still in service at the time of making this video. In fact, its incredible extended service life is slowly reaching 70 years. The KC-135 made its maiden flight on August 31, 1956, and officially entered operational service in June 1957. Meanwhile, the extender is already being put out to pasture, being replaced by the KC-46 Pegasus, an aerial tanker based on the Boeing 767. The first extender to be retired was tail number 86-0036, which was transferred in July 2020 to the 309th Aerospace Maintenance and Regeneration Group for storage at the Boneyard at Davis-Monthan Air Force Base, Arizona. Fast forward to January 2023, and the US Air Force announced that all KC-10s would be retired by September 30, 2024. With this retirement date looming, it's hard to know whether we should be discussing the aircraft type in the present tense or past tense. Indeed, as the months go by, the aircraft type will most certainly become less and less active. In fact, as a result of the command decision to retire the KC-10 later this year, the extender's last combat sortie actually took place on October 5, 2023. On January 11, 2024, the last active-duty wing to operate the aircraft, the 9th Air Refueling Squadron of the 60th Air Mobility Wing at Travis Air Force Base, California, consigned its flagship, tail number 79-1946, to that same boneyard. In an interview, 9th ARS Commander Lieutenant Colonel Andrew Bayer explained why the unit had dubbed the extender its flagship, saying, "What's so awesome is this airplane has a long history. It was in Operations Urgent Fury, Enduring Freedom, Allies Refuge, Desert Storm, Iraqi Freedom, New Dawn, Inherent Resolve, you name it, this jet has seen it." The KC-10 extender was more flexible than the KC-135 Stratotanker and lends itself much better to joint service air operations. This is largely due to a hose and drogue system that's more compatible with US Navy, US Marine Corps, and most allied warbirds. It can serve all aircraft in one mission. By contrast, the Stratotanker only uses a boom system, which is solely compatible with US Air Force aircraft. Although the official full retirement date for the KC-10 is just a few months away, preservation-minded aviation museum curators haven't wasted any time acquiring the already retired airframes to preserve them for posterity. Three of these venerable gas-toting warbirds have been converted to static displays. Their tail numbers and locations are as follows. Tail number 79-0433 is parked at the Air Mobility Command Museum at Dover Air Force Base, Delaware. This specimen is of particular historical significance and sentimental value, as it was the very first extender to be produced and was used for testing and development before entering service in 1981. Tail number 84-0185 can be found at the Marchfield Air Museum at March Air Reserve Base in Riverside, California. And finally, tail number 84-0191 is located at the Air Park of the National Museum of the United States Air Force at Wright-Patterson Air Force Base in the vicinity of the city of Dayton, Ohio. Time will tell if any additional KC-10s get selected for museum display. What are your thoughts on the KC-10 extender? Do you think it's being retired prematurely? Let us know what you think by leaving a comment. Simple Flying publishes over 150 articles every week. If you're looking for the latest aviation news and insights, visit simpleflying.com.